Okay, so features of a correctly trimmed tray is that I see a notch open opposite to each frenum inside the patient's mouth. It's 2 to 3 millimeter away from the tissue while in functional position. This patient has 2 buccal frenae, so I have 2 buccal notches. The buccal flange runs 2 to 3 millimeters, also short from the sulcus, and the buccal pouch area, or the distobuccal part of the flange, runs deeper than the rest of the flange, and this is the correct anatomy, because all of these borders are limited by limiting structures. You remember them, but this one is not limited by structure. The closest structure here is the lateral pterygoid, and even with the maximum opening, it just comes close. It even doesn't touch the border. It's not like these limiting structures, okay? Anatomical structures. So this is not limited, and so that's why it's deeper. I wanted you to see it first on the tray. Now we're going to see them inside the patient's mouth. Okay, so you can see the relief around the labial frenum. The relief of the labial frenum, I don't need to see it laterally, because you know that the labial frenum doesn't move laterally. We just move it down. You can see the relief beneath the lip, in the labial flange. You can see the relief with the buccal frenae, with lateral movement. And you can see the relief of the buccal flange with the cheek down, okay? And the buccal pouch area, sometimes you couldn't see it from the vision. You need to measure it by your finger or using the mirror, okay?